Good morning, students. In the ellipse, we are having special methods. Arc of circles method or foci method, otherwise intersecting arcs method. In this problem, major axis 120, minor axis 80. Now I am drawing the major axis length. Draw a horizontal line. Left end A, right end B, this is going to be major axis. For the major axis, we have to locate its midpoint. Name that midpoint as a O. Passing through O, draw a perpendicular line above major axis 40, below major axis 40. Top point, I am naming it as C. Bottom point, I am naming it as D. CD is going to be its minor axis. After getting the major axis and minor axis, and these minor axis, major axis intersecting at the point O. After getting this AB, CD, its midpoint O, how to get its respective foci? Now, half of the major axis length is going to be radius. Now, it is AO or OB. And minor axis ends are the centers. You have to cut the major axis, you will get the respective foci. Now, you can see AB is going to be its half of the major axis length. D is going to be center. I am drawing one arc on OB. You are getting arc on OB. This is F2. AO is going to be radius. Minor axis end at the center. Draw another arc. You will get F1. We are getting F1 and F2. After getting F1 and F2, now choose F1O or OF2. I am choosing F1O is going to be considerable length. On F1O, you have to divide some equal divisions. Now I am dividing it, some equal divisions. First point, second point, third point, and fourth point. First division, second division, third division. By using acute angle method, dividing a straight line into n number of equal parts. First, second, third. Now, F1O is divided into 4 equal parts. How many equal parts? 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. After getting this F1O into equal number of divisions, next step is going to be A1 is going to be radius. I am writing here. A1 radius. A1 is the radius. And F1 is the center. F1 is the center. You have to draw two arcs above the major axis, below the major axis. A1 is going to be its radius. F1 is going to be center. You have to draw two arcs. Similarly, A1 is radius and F2 is the center. A1 is going to be radius, F2 is going to be center. Draw two arcs above the major axis, below the major axis. Now, A1 is going to be radius. We are having 4 arcs above them, 4 arcs related to major axis. This region I am considering P portion, this is Q portion, this is R portion, this is going to be S portion. Now, after dividing these portions, next step is going to be B1 radius. B1 is the radius. B1 is the radius. F1 as a center. F1 is a center. B1 is going to be radius. F1 is going to be center. You have to cut arc in the Q-th portion. So this is going to be exactly B1 radius. Again, this is going to be B1 radius. So F1 as a center, B1 as the radius, you have to cut the previous arcs in the Q portion, in R portion. Similarly, B1 as radius, F2 as a center. B1 as a radius, F2 as a center, you have to cut the arc in P portion, arc in S portion. Now, this is going to be another point. This is going to be radius B1. Again, this is going to be B1 radius. Now, we are getting 4 points. This is P1, Q1, R1, S1. After getting all these points, next step, A2 is going to be radius. A2 is going to be radius. F1 is the center. 2 arcs. Again, A2 is going to be radius. F2 is going to be center. 2 arcs. Above the major axis, below the major axis. So this length is how much? A2. After getting this, then B2 is going to be radius. F1 as a center. B2 is going to be radius. F1 as a center, you have to cut the arc in Q portion, arc in S portion, Q portion and R portion. So therefore, this is B2, this is B2. So you are getting Q2, R2. This length I am showing it as B2. So this length I am showing it as B2. Then B2 is going to be radius. F2 as a center. F2 as a center, B2 is going to be radius, F2 as a center, you have to cut the arc in P portion, arc in S portion. So, these two. What is this radius? B2. What is this radius? B2. So, therefore, you are getting P2 and S2. So finally we are getting P2, Q2, R2, S2. So next procedure, A3 is going to be radius. F1 is the center. A3 is going to be radius. And F1 is the center. This is A3 radius. Again, A3 radius. F1 as a center. Now, A3 as a radius, F2 as a center. A3 is going to be its radius, F2 is going to be center. Draw arcs in Q portion, R portion. So therefore, this length is going to be A3, and this length is going to be A3. After getting these concern arcs, P portion, Q portion, R portion, S portion. Now, you have to consider B3 is going to be its radius. B3 is going to be its radius. Fn as a center. B3 is going to be its radius. Fn as a center. You have to cut the Q portion point. So therefore, it becomes bit. B3. Here also B3. You are getting here Q3 R3. Similarly, B3 is going to be radius, Fn as center, you did it. B3 as radius, F2 as a center. Now F2 as a center, this is going to be radius B3. This is P3. This is B3. This becomes S3. You have obtained the concern points. Those concern points P1, P2, P3, Q3, Q2, Q1, R1, R2, R3, S3, S2, S1. Now all these points are going to be joined by using HB pencil as a smooth curve. Starting from A, end point of major axis, A to P1, P1 to P2, P2 to P3, P3 to C, C to 3 Q1, Q1 to Q2, Q1 to Q1, Q1 to B, B to R1, R1 to R2, R2 to R3, R3 to D, D to S3, S3 to S2, S2 to S1, and S1 to B, A. Now you can observe you are having A, P1, P2, P3, C, Q3, Q1, Q2, Q1, B, R1, R2, R3, D, S3, S2, S1 is a form of an ellipse. Now for this one, how to draw a tangent and normal. Suppose you have to locate any point on a curve, any point on a curve from a distance from major axis, distance from minor axis, and distance from its focus. Its focal. Now I am considering a point. Considering a point. This is going to be point I am choosing. This is going to be point M. M is going to be point. M is going to be joined with F1. F1 M is a straight line. M F2 is going to be straight line. Now you can see that F1 M F2 use is going to be acute angle. Now for this acute angle you have to draw a perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisector. How to draw the perpendicular bisector? Some convenient radius from M, draw one considerable radius. This is going to be concern points on F1 M, F2 M. I am choosing these points Z and K. So again, this considerable radius is going to be existing. G is a center, another arc, K is a center, another arc. This is going to be L. Now, how to join the points L and M. This is going to be perpendicular bisector for this respective acute angle. This is going to be a normal N1 and N2. Perpendicular to this N1 and N2 line, you have to draw a perpendicular which is going to be its tangent, T1 and T2. So this is the procedure for foci method. Thank you.